When atoms bond, their valence electrons are redistributed in ways that make the atoms more stable. The way in which the electrons are redistributed determines the type of bonding. In Chapter 5, you read that main group metals tend to lose electrons to form positive ions, or cations, and nonmetals tend to gain electrons to form negative ions, or anions. Chemical bonding that results from the electrical attraction between cations and ions is called ionic bonding. In purely ionic bonding, anions completely give up electrons to other atoms, as illustrated in Figure 1 on the next page. In contrast, atoms joined by ionic bonding, atoms joined by covalent bonding share electrons. Covalent bonding results from the sharing of electron pairs between two atoms. In a purely covalent bond, the shared atoms are owned equally by two bonded atoms.
Now, what did he just say? Oh, yeah. We got some examples to show y'all. Pause. This is an example of a covalent bond. Covalent bonds involve atoms that share electrons. In this example, you could see the headphones are the electrons and the people are the atoms. Pause. In this example, it's an ionic bond. An ionic bond is whenever an atom loses or gains an electron. The headphones were the electron, and the atom took the electron from another atom.
Pause.
This is an example of a covalent bond. The electron of the ball was passed to a different atom so that way they could form a full outer electron shell. This was an example of an ionic bond because one of the atoms took the valence electron, which was the ball, and used it to fill its outer valence electron shell.